What do you think? Do you think it's possible to forge weld niobium? See, that's my problem. As soon as I get an idea in my head, I don't know if I can do it or not, I just have to drop everything and chase it. So that's what we're gonna try today. We're gonna try to see if we can forge weld niobium together. Let's get in the shop here. So the niobium is mostly used in the aerospace industry because it has such a ridiculous melting point. This is, just for context, steel melts at about 2800 degrees Fahrenheit. Titanium melts at about 3000 degrees, and a lot of, or most of the materials we work, actually anything I've worked except for this, melts at around that, and niobium melts at like 4500 degrees Fahrenheit. So it is a monster, and that's why I'm just super intrigued to see if we can weld this. So I'm gonna start cutting this up, and we're gonna start making, I guess, a billet, even though it's just gonna be all niobium. And if you're ever looking for some of this material or other aerospace materials, check out Sack and Metals, as they supplied me with this. So huge thank you to them. So I know it's pretty aggressive to try to do this, but I was thinking about it. I'm like, wouldn't it be so cool if you could actually pull this off? So it's basically just a big experiment today, like everything else we do around here pretty much. But anyways, I'm gonna just start cutting this stuff here. Oh man, cut this here and gonna give it an honest go. Hopefully we're walking away with the prize, but you never know around here, so. Should actually check that that's 2 inches before I just cut it off and zoom that, you know? Check twice, cut once, except on Friday, check 3 times, then cut. Beautiful. So I've just about got all the pieces lined up here. I'll just show you what's going on. So this is the niobium I want to weld here. And what I've decided to do is I'm actually going to put it into a case of niobium. And the reason I'm putting it in a case is because I want to make sure that there's no oxidization going on the inside. So I'm actually going to try to purge it with argon. Argon is an inert gas. You use it for arc welding all the time. Never tried it for forge welding, so that's going to be interesting. But essentially what's going to happen is the argon's going to come in here with a little bit of pressure, and then it should flow through, and then I'll put this on the other side and it'll vent out. So how that works in the forge is I'm going to put this tube here and weld that on. And because niobium melts at such an extreme temperature, this is actually niobium as well, so it doesn't melt. Then what I'm gonna do is weld this steel pipe onto the niobium just to make a longer handle. Then I'm gonna weld on a nipple here so that then I can weld on, or screw on my hose, which is where the argon will feed into. So it was a little bit of a weird scenario. I've never tried anything like this before, but that's what I'm gonna attempt. That's my swing at the, that doesn't make sense. That's my gong show of a setup right there. Does that make sense? Is that clear as mud? Tunka 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 tunka. Okay, so we got it all welded up, and this thing is actually the most beautiful thing I've ever made in my whole entire life. So it's pretty cool. But what is going on with this weird thing up there is that because the niobium melts at such a extreme high temperature, I have to use the coal or coke forge, because the propane won't get hot enough. So what I was worried about with having the vent hole on this side is because I'm jamming it in the coke and coal, so I'm going to get debris and bits in there, and then that will not make it weld. So I've got a hole, a tube, and then a little hole so that the gas can still go through, but hopefully debris won't get in, and if they do get into this, then they won't get into this. That's like the longest sentence to say that it's to keep stuff from not getting into my billet. Okay, so that's pretty cool. And I got it hooked up to the line, guys. Check it out. So I'm gonna actually turn it on. I got 5 PSI hooked up right now. And let's see if it, you probably can't hear that, but it is coming through. It's hot, coming through there. So that's pretty cool. Just admiring my beautiful work, craftsmanship. All right, I'm actually done. Okay, let's go get the forge started, guys. Ah, oh, Tim, quit while you're ahead. That ship sailed a long time ago. So I'm just gonna start cleaning out the cool forge here, and we are gonna get a whopper of a fire going. So I just got some new bags of coke. Let's load it up here. Oh, okay, that was the head. Yes, it was. Oh, a lesser man would have died. Whoa, Timmy! Look at all of that. That says, let's make some epic projects. So I'm just gonna let that heat up, and then I'm just gonna get set up here so that I can get everything ready. Pull this off, hopefully. Okay, we got everything set up. So this is gonna be the tank behind here. Got it strapped down. So I'm gonna have this in here, bring it out here, try to get the first couple passes on it. Then I can take the air off, argon, not air. And then I can go over to the hammer if we get that far. Let's see how this all works out. So let's get it in there and see how this goes. I'm pretty excited right now. It's pretty fun. So I'm gonna run this at just got it at about 5 PSI or 6. Hopefully that'll be enough to keep us clean. And let's jam it into this massive heap of fire. And then what I'm gonna do is turn the fan on. And then we'll slowly bring it up the temperature, and then at the end, we'll just floor it and get it as hot as we can possibly get it. Hard to know what 4,500 degrees Fahrenheit looks like. Oh yeah, that's looking really good in there. I can't see anything, it's just white. We'll leave it for another like 2 minutes and then we'll just go for it and see what happens. I can't even see it, it's just, it's too bright. All right, here we go, guys. Holy moly, man. I have never seen something that bright come out of the forge before. That is incredible. Thank you. take a look at that. I was really convinced that I had gotten that. Okay, so interesting, hey? And it does look like we had some like oxidization, like the side of the case is completely gone. And I was worried about that because there's so much oxygen in the forge that it's sort of like an oxyacetylene torch. So it just oxidizes, burns away. But I don't think we got anything of a fusion there. It was also interesting, on the first heat, I had completely lost the front knob. That was my vent tube. Like, it was all gone. I don't know where it is. Probably burned up. And then luckily I got a second heat on that handle, but it also blew out on me, hey? Okay, so it's a new day, and I've been thinking about it a little bit, and I'm gonna try this one more time. Just really wanted to make sure that I am convinced that this isn't gonna work. And one of the things that I felt like on the first billet that wasn't good, well, as it turned out wasn't good, was possibly the vent hole for the argon to come through, because when I pulled it out the first time, that part of it was all gone, like that extra tube that I welded on. So I'm wondering if maybe the argon wasn't going through, if that's the case, and I had a direct hole in the case, and it would have oxidized, and that would have wrecked it right from that point. So what I'm gonna try to do is cut this more material for another billet, but then what I'm gonna do differently is I'm actually not gonna try to purge it. I'm just gonna seal it up, make it a true canister, and then hope that it's pretty clean on the inside, and then we'll just try welding it again. But I'm also going to add quite a few more layers to the side of it, because that was the other problem, that basically the canister had oxidized, reacted with the oxygen so bad that it actually dissipated, burned out, wasn't there, and that's a big problem too. So those are the two things that I'm gonna try to fix, just to give this one more shot, because I don't wanna be putting my head down at the end of the day not 100% convinced that this won't work. So we're gonna quickly do this one more time. Gotta plug my saw in. The bandsaw blade is dull, and it was not that old when I started cutting this niobium. It's just ridiculous how fast it burns through the blade. You know what? I'm actually just gonna use a grinder and a zip disc instead of burning through another $50 worth of bandsaw blades for 12 cuts. That's ridiculous. Okay, got all the parts cut. I'm gonna start cleaning them here. Right, it's game on here. So I'm gonna get this in here. Basically, the biggest difference, no vent holes, and then I've put literally three layers of the niobium around that internal core part that I wanna keep. Now we're just gonna heat it up, see what happens. All right, here we go. All right, here we go. That was way hotter than the first time. Just checking it out to see if I can see anything. All right, looks good still. Nested down there. It's probably hard to tell on camera what it looks like, and it's even hard in real life, it's overexposed. And that's bright. I'll do it one more time here, and then Maybe we'll take it over to the power hammer and give it some stomps. All right, here we go. All right, handles down. Interesting, hey? It's like something burning there on the side. It's probably hard to see. It's too bad I lost the handle, but I still want to run it one time on the hammer. So I'm gonna get that going and we'll try it out. Is so crazy because under the power hammer I couldn't tell that it wasn't a solid mass. Typically with steel, if it's delaminated, you can feel that sort of give under the hammer, but this stuff is so hard and tough that it just feels solid. Even with the hand hammer on the first pass, I couldn't feel any difference. There is no fusion at all. I can see every single layer, so nothing welded. It's also surprising too, because with the TIG welding, you would think that it would weld, because the TIG weld's actually pretty good, right? Crazy. I guess I'm out of time and resources, as they say, for this project. Stuff's expensive. I can't think of any other better options at this point to really get it in, you know, in a cool forge. I guess you'd have to go to like a 100% controlled environment. I don't know what that looks like or what that is, but if you've got some ideas that you think would work better, I'm open to hear it, because that's as far as I can take it for right now. So sorry that it's not a really successful video, but at the same time, you know, we took the risk knowing that this might not work, and now we know that that's not as easy as just sticking it in the forge and welding it up. Anyways, what more is there to say? Thanks for watching. Always appreciate it. And look forward to seeing you in the next video, when hopefully I can make something that actually turns out awesome. See you in the next video.